The Lexus IS will always hold a special place in my heart because it was one of the first Lexus models to be built with younger buyers in mind. When the first generation model came out back in 2001, it was a radical departure from what we expected from Lexus because here we had a compact luxury sedan that was rear-wheel drive. It came standard with a straight six under the hood and it had available manual transmission. Now, unfortunately for Lexus, the current generation IS has lost a lot of that first model's luster. So for 2021, Lexus is making some pretty extensive updates to the IS this year. It's still based off of the third generation model, so before you go thinking this is an all new version, Lexus essentially just reskinned the exterior styling, gave us some new technology on the inside, and the company has said that they've greatly improved the handling dynamics to make this thing an extremely fun to drive sports sedan. Now the new Lexus IS will continue to have an uphill battle in the US with everybody buying crossovers, but the big question I want answered, with its new styling in the front and the rear and updated technology and improved handling, has Lexus made enough changes to the IS to keep this thing relevant? That's what we're here to find out. Hey guys, before we get started on the Lexus IS review, I want to tell you about this amazing opportunity to win an even cooler Tesla versus the one that I'm standing by. I'm talking about a one-of-a-kind brand new Model X Performance tuned by our friends over at Unplugged Performance. You know, the ones who build those crazy body kits for all those performance-oriented Teslas. You'll not only win that insane car, but an additional $20,000 in cash. All you have to do to enter for a chance to win is to click on the link in the description below. It'll direct you over to our friends over at omaze.com/redline, where you'll enter for a chance to win this insane car, plus the cash, and to support a great cause. Now, when the third generation IS came out back in 2014, I was not the biggest fan of the styling. In fact, today, I don't even think the current car has aged very well, which is why I'm happy to say that Lexus has made some pretty nice upgrades to the IS for 2021. This is a far better looking sedan they debuted like 7-8 years ago. And really, this is the way it should have looked when the car first came out. But you should remember, this is still based off of the third generation model. Lexus did not invest on an all new platform like Acura did for the all new TLX. Now, as you can see, this particular one that I'm showing you is a very nice color combination. This is the ultrasonic blue pearl color. This is an IS350 F-Sport with the company's all-wheel drive system. You can see the front fascia wears the current corporate Lexus face. You have the spindle grille front and center. It's got these very nice, big, intricate L's that kind of make up the inner part of the grille. You've got these full LED headlights, which my tester has the upgraded triple beam, full LED headlights with an LED daytime running light and LED low and high beams. Down here, you can see some of the vents are fake, but you can see with the black accents and this bright blue color, this is a really attractive looking sedan that I think Lexus did a great job making it look as new as it can, considering this is based off of an old platform. Now, as you can see, looking at the rest of the profile, this is a compact luxury sports sedan. So it competes with cars like the BMW 3 Series, an Audi A4, Mercedes-Benz C-Class, and even a Tesla Model 3. And Lexus did stretch this thing out a little bit more for the refresh. It stretches at around 185.7 inches long, about 1.2 inches longer. It still rides on the same 110 inch long wheelbase. Lexus also made this car about 1.2 inches wider to give this thing a sportier stance. Now, as you can see, my particular tester has a dynamic handling package that rolls in these 19 inch BBS wheels, which are a little bit more lightweight. I like the black finish. I'm surprised to see that Lexus didn't kind of paint the brake calipers to make this thing stand out. It would have been nice if it had blue or red painted calipers. It's got a staggered wheel setup, especially if you guys go for the rear drive model. My particular one is an all-wheel drive version, as you guys can see. Now, you can see here as well, the roof just got a standard sunroof. Lexus doesn't offer a panel roof on this thing. And the rest of the side profile here looks pretty similar to the pre-refreshed models. There's a lot more kind of edges and creases here at the lower end. And then when you look at the rear of this car, you can see there's a big changes that Lexus made to this thing this year. I don't particularly like the rear end design of this car. I think the trunk lid in particular, for me, kind of makes this thing look like a transformer, like a robot per se. I do like how they've inverted the rear taillights of this thing. It's got the full LED taillights, although the turn signals are an incandescent design. The reverse lights and brake lights are LEDs. You can see they've got this this connecting portion here for the LED taillights. You've got these nice dual exhaust tips down here, which are actually a real exhaust tip. Remember, this still has the same 3.5 liter V6 engine, so we'll fire it up and you can hear how it sounds. All right, so it's time to fire up that tried and true V6 and let's hear how it sounds. I do. Sorry. Oh man, there's old people coming right now. Should we wait?
Oh, whatever.
All right, so let's fire up that old V6 or that tried and true V6 and see how it sounds. Now the nice thing about this car is there's no silly limiter on it, and it actually still makes a pretty nice growl.
I don't know if there's a difference in toggling to Sport Plus. I did, but okay. It didn't do anything until halfway through. So.
It's fine. It actually sounded better than the Genesis. Now Lexus and Toyota make a pretty sweet sounding V6, so we'll talk about that more when we go into the test drive. Now opening up the trunk capacity, I don't have full figures yet for the cargo capacity. Lexus doesn't have that available yet as of this filming, but you can see here the current Lexus IS has a pretty small trunk. I think it measures under 12 cubic feet. This looks pretty similar. The seats do remain a 60-40 folding design though.
Now moving on to the interior of the new 2021 IS, for how much effort Lexus put into changing the exterior look of this car, the inside is definitely more of a playing it safe, maybe even lazier effort. There just aren't enough changes for me to make this thing feel as new on the inside as it does on the outside. As you can see, my tester is the F-Sport model. It includes this really interesting gray matte finish wood. It's like a genuine wood. It actually feels really nice. I like it. The black interior of my tester, however, is pretty dark. You can go for a red or a new Lux, or I'm sorry, a beige leather or even a gray leather. Lexus offers that, although I wish mine had a little bit more color. You can see the door panel is pretty much the same. There's a couple of new patterns there. More of that wood grain, which is interesting, is carried through. You have a silver painted plastic door handle. It's hard touch plastic down here, but soft touch on this upper portion. When I shut the door, it has a relatively solid sounding thunk. Remember, it's not a new platform. Now the key fob also hasn't changed. This is the older Lexus key fob. They do have a newer key fob on some of their other models. The engine start stop button is a little bit higher up on the dash. And as you can see, the F-Sport model includes this 8-inch full LCD display, which is definitely looking a little bit small. It's got that cool Lexus LFA-style gauge pod that does move to the side or to the center by pushing a button on the steering wheel. That's a pretty cool feature, or it was cool, you know, 10 years ago. It's starting to look a little small now. I do like how it still moves, and if you start switching over the drive mode, you can see it kind of changes the way this looks. Sport Plus is the one that gives you the all white display, which is nice. You can see there is the newest change, or the biggest change for the interior, this new 10.25-inch touchscreen. Now you can see Lexus has pushed the screen out much farther so I can reach this to touch, which is nice. You can see it's got Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, but it is not wireless. The screen itself is a huge improvement, although, you know, when you go back to the Lexus system here, this looks incredibly old. Don't love that. You can see when you use the, you know, home button down here by the trackpad, you can see those are your usual different sources. The GPS is looking pretty old. The audio system, you can see, looks kind of old. You can still do the split screen thing if you'd like. So really, most of you are probably just going to want to use the Apple CarPlay, which definitely makes the interior feel a lot more modern. Everything else about this interior is pretty much the same. The dashboard has a soft touch injection molded plastic with some faux stitching. There's some genuine stitching here on the instrument panel hood. This over here is also soft touch, which is nice. The steering wheel is manual tilt and telescoping, which is funny because I believe Lexus offers a power tilt and telescope if you guys go for a luxury package. The center stack here hasn't changed. The vents look slightly different. They added some piano black plastic trim here, which just shows fingerprints like crazy. You still have these touch sensitive slider here for the dual zone climate control, these very small buttons, a CD player as well. Who the heck still uses that? The vents you can see on the driver's side and the passenger side are now a circular vent, so that's a new addition as well. The steering wheel airbag cover looks slightly different, but why couldn't Lexus put a new steering wheel on this car? It still has that old Toyota cruise control stock here. Lexus has a newer steering wheel in the ES. They should have put it in this car. I don't understand why not. You got a heated steering wheel, which is nice. You have heated and ventilated seats, which is good. This is controlling the 6-speed automatic, which is a very old school gated shifter. When you put the vehicle into reverse, you can see there's a 360 camera with a top-down view. The graphics look okay, although I've been seeing better graphics on more mainstream brands, Toyota's including, so you have to, you know, wonder what they're doing here. You can see the trackpad remains, but if you'd like, you can also use it as a touchscreen, and that works whenever you're driving, which is nice. Your drive mode selector is over here. You've got a few more buttons here for your brake hold, stability control off. There's a snow mode. This is a nice padded area here where you can rest your elbows. You've got two cup holders, and the storage bin here is relatively good size. It's pretty deep, but it is a little bit lacking here on this part because of this massive CD player, which Lexus could get rid of, and I could have even more storage over there. The seats, you can see the F-Sport model has specific seats. They adjust in 12 different ways, although my tester doesn't have memory seats for the driver, which is frustrating. The glove compartment, you can see, is an average size. It's stamped but not lined with felt. And then above me, just a standard sunroof. Lexus does not offer a panel roof on this car. So overall, the interior is the biggest letdown about this refresh, aside from the new screen here and some new color options. It is basically the same car that we saw back in 2013. Now, getting into the back seat of the new IS, the old one had a pretty cramped back seat. Remember, this is a compact luxury sports sedan. And this new one here, I don't have official figures yet as of the filming, but you will see there's a large hump here that does intrude into your space. Remember, this is a rear drive chassis. And I'd probably say this thing has around 35, 36 inches of legroom. It's pretty much on par with other compact luxury sedans in the segment. In terms of features, I've got rear seat air vents, but you don't have like your own set of climate control systems back here. You have a nice armrest that folds down. Lexus gives you these pop-out cup holders, but there's no additional storage here. You have two map pockets, and then the materials back here are also soft touch, just like the front seats. But if you're looking for like USB ports back here or heated rear seats, I'm sorry, you're gonna have to look at the competition. Now, underneath the hood of the 2021 IS, I'm pretty sad to report that Lexus didn't make any changes to the powertrain. You still have a choice of three different engine combinations, from a 2-liter turbo four cylinder to two 3.5-liter V6. The IS350 continues to be powered by the company's high output 3.5-liter V6. It's got direct and port injection. It's a naturally aspirated V6. In a world full of turbocharged competitors, and of course electric competitors like Tesla, this seems pretty old school. So a lot of you Lexus enthusiasts and faithful could be happy about that because it's Lexus reliability. But you should know the output figures are 311 horsepower and 280 pound-feet of torque. Those numbers were excellent about 15 years ago. So Lexus really should have upped the power on this thing. And they do have a 3.5-liter twin-turbo V6 in the LS500. I'm surprised that I don't see that underneath the hood of this vehicle, although Lexus did patent the name IS500. So there could be a chance that Lexus may do an IS500 or an ISF with the 5-liter V8, so we'll have to wait and see. But this particular powertrain with all-wheel drive is mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission, 6 speeds when even a Toyota Camry has an 8-speed auto, so you really see how dated this is. When you guys go for a rear-drive IS, it will give you the 8-speed automatic, and you can also get that with a limited slip differential. Now, fuel economy for this particular one is rated at 19 in the city, 26 on the highway. Premium is recommended. I don't have the final weight figures yet, but you should know this is down on power compared to its competitors by as much as 100 horsepower, depending on which one you're looking at. So obviously you guys can pretty much sense my disappointment in Lexus, how, you know, the IS is just merely a refresh of an old model. The biggest disappointment, however, is the interior and the engines. They have not changed whatsoever. So the one I'm driving is an IS350 F-Sport with all-wheel drive. You can technically still buy this powertrain in the pre-refresh models. It has a 6-speed automatic transmission, and this is essentially the same kind of powertrain you're gonna get from a Toyota Camry with a V6. It has 10 more horsepower though than the Camry, like 12 more pound-feet of torque. The Camry technically has two more gears than this transmission. I will say that it is a responsive automatic. Like, I floored it there from a stop, and it actually was pretty good at downshifting, and it sounds good, although the noise is definitely synthesized. It's a screaming engine, so I like the naturally aspirated noise. If you guys are looking for a naturally aspirated V6, the Lexus is one of the few that still offers it, especially in a world full of turbocharged four cylinders. You may want to choose this for its V6 because you know it's going to be damn reliable. You know it's been built for so many years. Lexus has this powertrain down, you know, to a T in terms of build quality and just how long it's been around. Okay, so it feels like it'll get to 60 in probably 5.8 seconds, which is perfectly adequate, although the four-cylinder turbo competitors are quicker than this car still, but they won't be able to match this thing for noise. But I will say that the fake noise, some of you may not like that. I can turn that off right here through this little switch, and when I do that, it's definitely not as loud when you do that, but there was a slight shudder there from the automatic. This six-speed just, you know, was a great transmission 10 years ago, and today it's just starting to feel a little bit behind the times. Now, in terms of the rest of the car, Lexus has made changes to the suspension on this car to make it handle better. It still rides really well. This one has the adaptive variable suspension, so it has a very comfortable, controlled ride quality. I'm pretty impressed with how smooth the ride is, even in Sport Plus setting. The steering also provides a good amount of feedback. I like the way the overall, you know, car feels. It's just a really, you know, well-planted, you know, sporty, stiff-feeling car still, even though the chassis dates back to, you know, 2014. In terms of the rest of the driving dynamics, I find the seats to also be really comfortable, typical Lexus seats where they're soft, supportive. This one has a little bit more aggressive bolstering extensions to give this thing more of like that hugging feel because it's the F-Sport model. Visibility in the IS also is not bad. It's pretty much what I expect from this vehicle. It feels like I'm driving the same car aside from the infotainment system being pushed forward a little bit. The side mirrors haven't changed. The steering wheel looks the same. The gauge display looks the same. It still stays relatively quiet in here when you're not pushing the engine. It has those typical Lexus qualities. And then in terms of the safety tech, this is now the Lexus Safety System 2.5. So it's not like the newest system, but it has been upgraded from the 2.0 system that you got in the pre-refresh models. But really, the biggest disappointment is the fact that you can get a V6 Camry, which is front-wheel drive, and it gets to 60 in roughly the same amount of time as this car. And this is a Lexus. It's a Lexus that costs significantly more than a Toyota. And that's precisely why there should have been a 3.5-liter twin-turbo V6 under the hood. They've got that engine in the LS. I just don't understand why they couldn't have stuffed it into this car. It would have made for a huge improvement. It would have changed the driving dynamics completely. But you can't argue with that sound. I do like that sound a lot. So it's still a good engine. It's going to be a reliable engine. It's still a relatively sporty driving car. The problem is that the competition has moved significantly farther than this. And I question if Lexus has done enough. I question that. Now, in terms of fuel economy, 1926 is the MPG for this car. In my weeks, or my couple days of having it, it's been averaging around 22 mpg, so not bad gas mileage. Premium is recommended. I don't think you have to actually put premium in it. So decent gas mileage. This is a naturally aspirated engine, so typically it's going to get better gas mileage in the real world. But overall, still a nice driving luxury sports sedan that's still cramped on the inside, gets decent gas mileage, looks good, looks a lot better now. But is it enough? Have they done enough changes to make this thing still, you know, worthy of your consideration? So as you guys can imagine, I was pretty disappointed that the new IS is technically not an all-new version, but I am saying that I'm surprised to see that Lexus did a pretty good job with the overall design of this thing. I think it's a much better looking car, especially this particular, you know, version of the F-Sport package. But in terms of the driving dynamics, it still very much drives like an IS. It's very sporty yet comfortable. The interior is still on the cramped side, and the technology, Lexus did obviously improve the infotainment system and some of the features in this thing. It's a little bit easier to use, but I'm pretty disappointed with the powertrain. The engine is still the same. It has that lazy six-speed automatic. It's still very smooth. It's going to be reliable, but I just wish that Lexus had pushed the envelope with this thing a lot more, especially with new competitors like the all-new TLX that's coming out that has a twin-turbo V6. You can also get an Audi S4, for example, a 3 Series, a C-Class, an Audi A4, or even a Tesla Model 3. So the IS is pretty lacking in terms of being distinctive, and that's, I think, the biggest problem with the current model. So I'm pretty disappointed to see that we don't have like an IS500 or an ISF, although there is rumor that those models are coming, so you'll have to stay tuned if you guys really want to get a new IS. But speaking of which, if you're looking to buy one of these things, what's it going to cost? Well, Lexus did increase the price of this car by a little bit. It's about $500 more this year. It starts at around $39,000 for the base IS200 with rear drive. My particular one is the IS350 all-wheel drive with the F-Sport package, and that's roughly going to start around $46,000. Now, here's the kicker. My tester has roughly $10,000 worth of options on it, from the dynamic handling package to the F-Sport package to the Mark Levinson sound to the navigation system package to the upgraded
upgraded interior, which makes this thing around $56,000. 56 grand is a lot of money for this car. It's going to be more expensive than something like the new Acura TLX, more expensive than a Tesla Model 3, a little bit less expensive than its German competitors, but I would argue that the German competitors for a little bit more give you way more horsepower and a lot more technology on the inside. So really, unless you're a huge fan of Lexus and you want Lexus reliability, there's very little reason for me to choose this car until Lexus decides to upgrade the powertrain, give us an all-new platform. But with sedan sales continuing to shrink over the years to crossovers, I can see why Lexus also didn't want to spend that much R&D money in developing an all-new platform. But with all that said, I hope you guys have enjoyed my full overview on this 2021 Lexus IS350 with the F-Sport package. If you're also looking to see the latest cars I'm testing, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Redline_reviews, like us on Facebook, and as always, guys, please keep subscribing to the Redline Reviews YouTube channel for all the latest reviews. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you all in the next video. And just a friendly reminder, be sure to visit omaze.com/redline for a chance to win that insane Model X plus the cash and to support a great cause.